Hi, my name is Brooke Haggerty, the food chick. Welcome to today's episode of For the Love of Food. Today we're going to talk about some easy snack foods. My friends Kim and Chris recently had a baby, which means people are always stopping by. So she needs to have something that's in the house, that's easy to get to, easy to make, easy to freeze, easy to reheat, or just easy to make on the fly. So I talked to her, and I know she loves Mexican food. She and her fiance Chris both do. So they love Mexican food. I said, well, how about just do like little mini taco bites? And we can have something that's easy to freeze. You can pop them out, put them in your toaster oven if you need to heat them up for a small crowd, and it's easy. It's ready to go. Well, so we're going to do those today. While those are cooking, we're going to go over to my handy dandy little market bag here, Eat Your Veggies. No veggies involved in this bag today, though. It's all going to be about a high-protein snack today that's going to be easy to put together. And if you have young children at home, they can help you do it. It gets them involved and makes them happy. So let's get started on our spicy taco crunch bites. Okay, so what we're going to do, my oven is preset to 350 degrees. I do have it on my convection bake setting. If you don't have a convection oven, you can put it at 375 to 400 on a regular oven setting. We're going to make it for our spicy taco bites tonight. Try and say that one. For our spicy taco bites today, we're going to be using ground pork. We're going to be using red onion. We're going to be using a canned diced tomato, canned green chilies, some fresh garlic, and some hot pickled jalapenos. We've also got some cheddar cheese, and then we've got some sour cream back here to use for garnish, and of course we've got some fresh cilantro. We're also going to be using a beautiful chili powder and adobo seasoning today. So we're going to season up our meat ourselves. We're not going to use a pre-packaged taco seasoning. There's a lot of sodium in that. We're trying to take a little bit of that sodium out. So let me go ahead and let me finish chopping up my red onion here. I'm not going to be, these are going to be pretty, not big slices, but a small dice here. So we do a small dice on our red onion. This was a gorgeous red onion. I had started slicing it for something and I just put the slices aside. So now I'm just going to dice it. It's going to be wonderful in our spicy taco bites. Yum. This red onion is so vibrant. I just love the colors. Look how red, you know, beautiful red, purple. You've got that green in the center. I mean, it's just really, really, really pretty. So we've got our onion cut there. And again, not too big, not too little on there. You can go to your desired size. I've got some pork, some ground pork here. Of course, you can use whatever protein you like. Beef, turkey, you can do a combination of everything. It's gonna be wonderful. Let me backtrack a little bit. How are we gonna make these into the little bites? We are actually gonna be using phyllo dough today. I've got phyllo dough back here that's gonna go into my little mini muffin tins. It's gonna be fantastic. And again, easy to freeze, easy to make, easy to bite into. And I think your guests will be really, really happy with it. Let me just go ahead and put a little bit of chili powder in to my meat, just a little bit. We're probably gonna go about a quarter to a half a teaspoon in there, depending on how much you like. I've also got my adobo seasoning. A little bit of adobo seasoning in there. Again, about a quarter of a teaspoon there. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna mix these together. Get that down in there nice. Okay, let me go ahead and we're gonna cook this on the stovetop at about a medium-high heat with our red onion. And while that's cooking, we're gonna chop up our garlic and our pickled jalapenos and add that to our mix as well. It's gonna be a one-pot wonder in addition to our baking tin. So two pots, but I like the sound of one-pot wonder, don't you? Sounds fun. Okay, let me go ahead and turn my stovetop on. Put a little bit of extra virgin olive oil in the bottom of my pan. I'm gonna add my onions first. Okay, my onions are in. I'm gonna go ahead and let those do a little bit of a happy dance together. I'm gonna grab my pork. This is about 1 pound of ground pork. turn my heat down here a little bit. Remember, I do have an induction cooked up, so it does tend to cook a little bit faster at times. There we go. And we're gonna let this cook for just a minute or two, and then we're gonna add our tomatoes to this and our chili peppers, green chilies. We just want to get this meat and the onion combined and break that meat up as you go, because you don't want to have big globs of just meat in there. Okay, so that's browning nicely there. Okay, now I'm gonna take my green chilies. I'm gonna put about a half of my can in there and mix those up. Again, this is a very, very easy meal to put together. If you wanted to take this and put it into a taco salad instead of into the little bite size that we're gonna do, definitely you can do that. This is a nice mixture too that you can make in advance and use it later in the week. If you wanna turn this into regular tacos as well, you can do that. Okay, so we've got our green chilies in there. I'm gonna add a little bit of the diced tomatoes. I'm actually gonna strain those out a little bit so I don't have too much liquid in there. Now that I've got a little bit of liquid in there from the tomatoes and the green chilies, I'm gonna turn my heat back up some. And we're gonna let this get happy together. Cook down nice. While that's cooking on a medium high, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to cut up some garlic and some jalapenos. Again, I'm using a pickled jalapeno in here and some fresh garlic. I'm just gonna slice my garlic down nice and thin with my knife here. And I'm a big fan of garlic, so I'm gonna leave these slices fairly large. Even though they're thin slices, it's gonna be longer pieces. Here we go. Look at that. I love the smell of fresh garlic. You know, I'm all for, you know, I often use a minced garlic that's already been done for me. But there's nothing. You can't beat fresh garlic. Take it right, you know, peel it, get it going. Oh my gosh, this is nice. I know I'm cutting this a little bit more than I said I was going to. Oops. The beauty of cooking, it is not brain surgery. You can change it up as you go along. Okay, so I've got my garlic there. Let me grab some of these pickled jalapenos and put those in there as well. We've already got some heat from our adobo seasoning and our chili powder in there. So this is just gonna add a little bit more of a crunch factor as well. So let's go ahead and put these into our mix. Remember, we pre-seasoned our meat with our chili powder and our adobo, so we don't really need to add anything to that. Look how pretty this mix is. It's nice and bright. Of course, you could in season use fresh tomatoes in this. Oh my gosh, that would be amazing. Some big, beautiful beefsteaks cut down. Yum. So, okay. Our meat is cooking down. We're gonna let that cook down. We're gonna clear space over here because we're gonna bring our phyllo pastry out. And we've got our phyllo pastry, our little mini muffin tin. We're not gonna fill all the mini muffins in this. We're gonna do about 8 of them. We're gonna spray them very, very lightly with a cooking spray. This is an olive oil cooking spray, just very, very, very lightly. If you do it too heavy, the phyllo is so thin that it will seep through and you won't get that crispness that we are looking for. So, my phyllo pastry, you can buy this in your freezer section. You can keep it frozen or refrigerated. If you freeze it, which I highly recommend freezing it, it defrosts in no time at all. And we're not gonna be using all of this, so what I'm gonna do when I'm finished is I'm going to rewrap it, freeze it again, pop it right in my freezer, and you're good to go for about 6-8 months, and probably even longer than that. But it's not gonna last in my refrigerator for that long, because I'm gonna be doing different things with it. As a matter of fact, soon we're gonna be doing my chicken pot pies with some phyllo, which are a lot of fun to do. So you see I've got my pizza cutter here. Let me take a couple of these sheets. I'm just gonna take 3 or 4 of these sheets. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 sheets of phyllo. Let me put my other aside. Get this wrapped back up again. Important thing with this phyllo is that when you're using it, that you get it wrapped. If you don't, whatever you're not using, get it wrapped back up right away with Saran wrap so it doesn't leave, so you don't lose your moisture. Or if you don't have time right away, use that plastic that it comes in, get it tight around there. I'm gonna leave that right back here now. I'm gonna turn my mix over here down. Wow, does that ever look good? Using that ground meat, you know, it doesn't take very long for that to cook. So we've got our phyllo sheets here. I'm gonna take my pizza cutter and I'm just gonna cut some sheets. Again, the size of your sheet here is going to depend on the size of your muffin tin. This is a mini muffin tin. If you're using a larger muffin tin, then of course you're gonna wanna have a larger sheet. So let's see what I have here. That looks like that should be about right. I'm gonna put 2 in my bottom. I'm gonna cross them so that they can sustain my mix. And they're gonna cook beautifully in there. Again, use your eyes, judge what you need. Cooking, again, as I say so very often, you know, cooking is not brain surgery. It's very subjective. Use your eyes, use your nose, to sort of, you know, gauge how you're doing things. Let your senses help you out with your cooking. I think oftentimes people are afraid to use their senses when it comes to cooking. They don't trust themselves. We're always looking at different recipes and following recipes to the T. There are things, yes, you do need to follow the recipes to the T, but there's nothing wrong with getting adventurous and coming up with your own recipes. Or as I've said very often, taking and looking at 3 or 4 different recipes for the same item and making it your own, putting the things in there that you like. I've got a little bit of extra here. I think what I'm gonna do with these extra sheets, we're actually gonna make a double layer in here. So let's see what we have. We put this phyllo back here. I've got my meat mixture here. I'm going to drain this out because there is a lot of liquid in it. So I've got my strainer right, my colander right here. I'm gonna drain this out just a little bit, get that extra liquid off from there. You can see that liquid going down into there. Again, we don't want, because our phyllo is very, very thin, we don't want that excess coming through there. I'm gonna grab a paper towel, a couple paper towels here. And I'm just gonna push that right down to get rid of that excess liquid that we don't necessarily need. However, we can save that because you never know when you can use it for something else, because there's a lot of flavor packed into there. Oh yeah. Okay, here we go. Let's fill our little packets. Grab a spoon. I'm grabbing a small spoon here. We're gonna fill our packets. Look at that. Look how pretty that looks. I know you. Some of you might be eyeing up the cheese I have over here. Of course, we're going to have cheese in here. These are going to be quite delicious. I'm very excited about these. It smells really, really good. Again, going back to eating with your senses, using your senses other than taste when you're eating. Starting with your eyes, I'm seeing how pretty this looks. I'm smelling how amazing it smells. I'm thinking that the gentlemen who are helping me out with filming today are smelling it really good. I'm thinking my friends Kim and Chris are really gonna like this when they see this. And they're gonna see how easy it is. We're actually gonna eat, remember we had that, the other phyllo that I said I had a little bit extra? I'm gonna take this, I'm gonna add a little extra crunch factor in. I'm just gonna take these pieces, I'm gonna cut them in half. And I'm gonna create another layer. After I put a tiny bit of cheese, just a tiny bit. You just need a little bit. We're gonna put a little bit more on our second layer. These are gonna cook in our 350 degree convection oven for about 10 minutes. If you've got a conventional oven, it's only gonna, it's gonna be at 375 to 400 for about 12 minutes. Okay. Look at these. These are so cute. And when we add another layer of meat, it's gonna be like, wow. Wow, wow, wow. And I have just enough here. And push those right, see I'm pushing those right on top. And I'm leaving my bottom layers so that it can wrap around. Let's put a little bit more meat on these. Oh wow, this mix. You know, I love using ground pork. Ground pork, ground turkey, ground beef. Not everybody likes to use ground beef all the time. You could even use ground lamb in this if you wanted to. Any kind of ground, tofu, if you want to keep it vegetarian, use tofu. It'd be wonderful in this. Because it's really going to pack a lot of flavors with those tomatoes, the green chilies. We've got the jalapeno and the garlic in there. Okay, so those are dressed and ready. And you see, this has not taken me a long time at all. We're gonna put a little bit more cheese on the top. Oh yeah. And these are gonna go into our oven. These are gonna go into our oven for 10 minutes. Just until those edges get nice and crisp. So I'm gonna set my timer for 10 minutes and we're gonna start that. While those are cooking, we're gonna do a fun little treat. I started doing not too long ago. My husband and I are big snackers and we like protein. I love high protein snacks. You can't get much more high protein in a vegetarian snack than you can with using nuts. And trail mix, I love trail mix. And again, you know, we talked about my friends Kim and Chris, you know, they're looking for quick items, something that's easy to serve. They're both back to work recently after the birth of their beautiful daughter, Storm. So they need quick snack items. So I'm pulling out my bag here, not just my Eat Your Veggies bag, which I use at the farmer's markets. I cannot wait till farmer's market starts up again. Not too long, folks, not too long from now. I'm gonna use my handy dandy zipper bag here. I've also got some smaller bags that we will use because we're going to portion out as well. We're gonna make our own trail mix today, folks. I was at the grocery store yesterday. I went and I picked up some yogurt raisins. I picked up some fire roasted nut mix with sea salt, or you can buy individual nuts, the different kinds that you like. I also got some pumpkin seeds. These also have a little bit of sea salt in them. I got some sriracha peas because I love a little bit of heat. I got some wasabi peas in here too because I love, again, this is gonna be nice color too, in addition to the heat, some wasabi peas. I picked up, excuse me, some raw sunflower kernels. I didn't need to add some flour kernels with salt because I've already got two items here with salt in it. So we're not gonna need to add anything to this other than what we grabbed from the store. We're gonna mix it all up in this bag and then we're gonna portion out. It's gonna be easy to go to for a snack to take to work, if you're on the go to the gym before or after. I'm also gonna add banana chips to our trail mix today. Very excited about the banana chips. They're, again, additional crunch factor, and you get the potassium from the banana chips. Fantastic before or after workout. And then if you want to, dark chocolate covered almonds. If you want to throw a little chocolate in there for the mix, by all means do that. I don't think I'm gonna throw these into my mix today, but you know, it's don't be afraid to add a little chocolate to your trail mix. It's not going to be crazy. So I'm just gonna open my bags up. I'm probably gonna put about half of everything in here. We're gonna see what that looks like and we're gonna add to as we go if we need to. Starting with my wasabi peas. So I've got my wasabi peas there. I'm gonna go with my sriracha peas next. I just love these sriracha peas. And the great thing about this item as well, if you don't want these spicy things in there, if the kids are gonna be eating them, you can make two different styles. You can make one with spice, one without the spice. You can make whatever you want. And the kids will have fun doing this. They're gonna put their own favorite flavor profiles in there. Wonderful, wonderful way to get them involved in the kitchen with no cooking. Yeah, you can open the bags for them. Okay, that's my sunflower seeds are in there. Next, I'm gonna add my pumpkin seeds with sea salt. So that's our first item that has the salt in it. They're nice and pretty and bright green. About half of that bag. And again, use your own, the flavors that you like. Take the kids to the grocery store with you. Let them pick and choose what they like. And it'll be fun for them to do. It's a nice way to get them involved in the kitchen with you. Banana chips. My fire roasted nut mix with sea salt. This nut mix, I've got some almonds in here. I've got some cashews. I've got some peanuts. I've got some macadamia. Hazelnuts. A little bit of salt in here. Yeah, a little bit goes a long way in this mix. And I think also with the addition of the sriracha peas and the wasabi peas in this, with that heat, you don't need all that extra salt in there. Put a little bit more nuts in there. Nuts high in protein. It's a great way to get some energy. You see, we're just building this nice and neat. I'm gonna look in here real quick. Oh, those are looking good, good, good. Last but not least, I'm gonna add my yogurt raisins to our mix. Half of our yogurt raisins. Put those in the back. I'm gonna zip up my bag, take the air out, and I'm gonna mix it. Look how easy that is. Mix that all up in there. Now we've got some great easy snacks for the kids to take to school or to have after school. You've got some great easy snacks for you to take pre or post gym or to put in your bag on your way to work. You know, this is also if you need a breakfast on the go. What a great way to have breakfast on the go. I'm just gonna go ahead, I'm gonna mix, take my hand right in here. Woo-hoo. Look at that, make up my little Ziploc bags. This also is a great way for portion control to make sure you're not eating too much. You know, sometimes we tend to, if we see this big bag right in front of us, I mean, I know my husband and I do it, we just keep reaching in and grabbing it. But if I've got it portioned out, we know that this is all we're supposed to have. Now this is a large portion. I do, because I eat this a lot on my way, pre and post gym. So a regular size portion is gonna be about half of that. So this is one that, just a little snack size Ziploc bag. Kids, again, easy for your kids to do, hang out with you in the kitchen while you're doing some other things, and they can put this together. Again, a way to get your children involved with cooking. And so oftentimes, especially in today's society, we tend to rush through everything that we're doing. We're not taking the time to treat ourselves to good food, and we see how easy it can be. Even this nice little spicy taco bites that we're making, they're so cute, they're so adorable. You know, your kids can get involved with that if you want them to. It's just a nice way to stay together. I think food's a great way to bring families together. I'm gonna go ahead and put this to the side. I'm gonna get cleaned up. I've got about 2.5 minutes left to go on our spicy taco bites. And we're gonna pull those out and we're gonna see how delicious they are. I'll be right back. Okay, so my spicy taco bites have been in the oven for about 10 minutes. I'm gonna pull them out now. Oh, wait till you see these. They are so cute and adorable. Wow, nice crisp little edge there. You see that? Let's bring them over here. Oh yeah, oh, they smell good, they look good, and they look fun. This is a nice, fun food. Again, something that's gonna be easy to freeze for my friends Kim and Chris, or for anyone for that matter. If you don't wanna eat them all now, pop them in a freezer bag, put them in bottom side down. You don't wanna stack them, so you'll need a shelf by itself. But you can pop them into the toaster oven, cook them up real quick as a nice heat and eat for your friends when they come over to see your new baby or to just see you. Okay, so look at that little, oh. They come out so easy. Oh, there's my timer. They come out so easy. They're so cute. Oh, and they were so simple to make. And we're just gonna garnish them with just a little bit of sour cream. If you like, just a little bit of sour cream on each one. Oh yeah. I'll garnish the rest of those in a minute. I'm gonna put a little cilantro, nice little cilantro leaf on there. Oh, look how pretty, and I'm gonna taste it. Mmm. Absolutely delicious. Spicy, crunchy. You got the earthiness of that onion and the pop of the spice with the adobo seasoning and the chili powder. Fantastic. So my name's Brooke Haggerty. I'm the food chick. Thanks for joining me today for two easy snack items. Have a great day, everyone.